In a prior episode of our series Incoming, the Templin Institute produced something of a guide entitled Building Your Interstellar Navy. Among the many topics covered in that video was the role of Marines and troop transports in interstellar warfare. Even though this is something that was only touched upon briefly during the video, it's something that has nevertheless received a lot of discussion. So I'd like to take the opportunity to clarify some of my earlier points and produce something of an addendum. So if you haven't already seen Building Your Interstellar Navy, give it a watch. It's only, 40 minutes. Oh my god. Okay, so a brief summary of my point was this. I feel that in any interstellar navy, there are many benefits to incorporating the role typically assigned to aircraft carriers, that is, launching and receiving aircraft, across every other type of ship in the fleet. Battleships, cruisers, frigates, destroyers, corvettes, these ship types could all benefit from including a couple or even an entire wing of aircraft into their design. My rationale was that starfighters can supplement the existing role of these ships and expand their capabilities. So if you agree with that assessment, would it make sense then to take it a step further and incorporate the role of a troop transport into every ship type? Should frigates, destroyers, battleships, etc. all carry a regiment of Marines? My answer to this is no. While starfighters are able to supplement the capabilities of the warship they're assigned to, the use of Marines or naval infantry within interstellar naval warfare is limited. Better, I argued, to retain dedicated troop transports rather than trying to disperse large infantry formations across an entire battle fleet. Now, many people in the comments took this to mean that I didn't believe that Marines or naval infantry should be on ships at all. They brought up boarding actions and even internal security as the kind of things you might want dedicated Marines for. On our own world, the use of boarding actions in naval warfare has decreased to basically zero across history. In a conflict as large as World War II, it only happened a handful of times, and I have to think this trend will continue. When naval engagements are being fought across entire solar systems, the idea of sending a bunch of Marines to try to capture an enemy ship seems kind of impractical. But I do have to admit that the nature of space warfare seems to change from reality to reality, so who am I to say that boarding actions will never happen in the future? And on top of that, while boarding actions aren't happening between major powers at war, they are increasingly common when dealing with pirates and other criminal activity. So does this change my previous stance at all? Should every ship within an interstellar navy carry some sort of infantry regiment? And my answer is no. While I do agree that it makes sense for each ship type within an interstellar navy to have some sort of boarding action capability, that doesn't mean I think every ship needs to carry tanks, artillery, and enough Marines and support personnel to conduct a planetary invasion. Better to keep Marine formations that sized on dedicated troop transports, because on anything else they're going to be superfluous. I brought up the Pillar of Autumn, a light cruiser within the UNSC Navy, as something that didn't quite make sense to me. It was a cruiser that was apparently carrying an entire mechanized battalion. I was helpfully informed, however, that this was something of a special case. The reason for the large contingent of Marines on board the Pillar of Autumn was that the ship had been assigned a special clandestine mission to abduct a member of the Covenant's ruling caste. Normally, it wouldn't have had all those tanks and Marines and such on board. This makes sense to me, and I can accept it. I do have to wonder, though, if a light cruiser was the right ship for this mission. It probably wasn't designed to undertake planetary invasions as part of its original mandate, and I have to think that a carrier or troop transport would have made a smarter choice. But hey, the UNSC Navy was desperate, and maybe they couldn't spare anything else. But when it came to my point that tanks and artillery aren't useful in space warfare, we also had a lot of defenders of General Anakin Skywalker. During the Battle of Bothawui, Anakin Skywalker deployed numerous all-terrain tactical enforcers on asteroids, which were then used to ambush an incoming Separatist fleet. This to me, though, is just the exception that proves the rule. What Anakin Skywalker was doing here was innovative and brilliant, not just a run-of-the-mill tactic that happens all the time. It required a very specific set of circumstances to come to fruition, and shouldn't be planned on as part of standard operating procedure. So I hope that clarifies my opinion on the role of Marines in interstellar warfare. It makes sense for each ship type in a fleet to be able to conduct some sort of boarding action, but not a planetary invasion. And just because tanks were useful in a space battle once doesn't mean you should plan for that to be the case every time. But that, of course, is just my opinion. And even though every time someone disagrees with me, I become as furious as a raging volcano, I'd still like to hear your thoughts. Does it make sense to station a couple tanks on a frigate or destroyer just in case? Should boarding actions again be a critical aspect of naval strategy? Let me know in the comments below. And until next time, this has been a Templin Dispatch.